Hello, this is John Locke, and today I want to talk with you for just a few minutes about Google's mobile-first indexing and what that means for your website. Beginning in 2015, Google announced that they were going to give more favor toward sites that were mobile-friendly. At the time, this was called Mobilegeddon. Now, at the end of 2017, Google started rolling out something called mobile-first indexing. Now, it's the beginning of July 2018, and both myself and everybody I know is seeing mobile-first indexing rolling out to all the websites that they manage. So that means that Google is definitely pulling the trigger on this. Before we get into what mobile-first indexing is, let's look at what indexing is and how it relates to search results. When you type something into Google and you get a series of search results back, those results are coming from the index of all the web pages that Google has crawled, rendered, and brought back to Google and put them in their index. Google uses a spidering bot called Googlebot to go out and crawl links all throughout the web and try and index all the pages that exist on the web. Up until now in 2018, what you've seen in the Google index, meaning the search result pages, has been the desktop versions of sites. It's been a desktop first index, meaning if you have two versions of your site, say like a desktop version and a mobile version, that desktop version has been what's appeared in search results up to now. So with mobile-first indexing, Google now has a different user agent, and that's called Googlebot Smartphone. So basically, it's crawling link to link, indexing web pages as if it was a mobile phone. Here's how the indexing is changing in 2018. Like I said in the past, Google would try and crawl the desktop version of your site and then index that. That's changing now. What's happening now is they're crawling the mobile version of your site and indexing that. If your site does not have a mobile version of that page, then it will index the desktop version. Here's a myth that I would like to clear up that I've seen some confusion about. There are not two indexes for Google. There is only one index of search results. Meaning, if you're searching on desktop, you're not going to see an index of just desktop results. If you or your customers or searching on mobile or on desktop or tablet or anything else, you're going to see the same index of results. So mobile first indexing, the things that you need to be aware of. Here's what it doesn't affect. If your site is already mobile friendly, if you use one code base for both your desktop and your mobile site, if you're on your phone or you're on a tablet and it just kind of rearranges the content, you're fine. No changes. If you have something that's what they call either responsive design or adaptive design, that's the same thing, you're fine, no changes. Now, if you have a m.site, if you have a separate web address for the mobile pages on your site, if your site is configured in a way to where it dynamically gives different page content to mobile users versus desktop users, then you definitely need to pay attention because this update does affect you. Similarly, if you have a WordPress site and you've used a plugin like WP Touch to serve up different versions of your pages on mobile versus desktop, then this update will also affect you because those mobile pages are what Google is going to index and not the desktop version of your site. Also, if you have a site that uses AMP pages like Google AMP to have different pages, what Google is going to index is the mobile non-AMP versions of those pages. It's not going to index the AMP pages that might appear at the top of the search results in the carousel, but what's going to get indexed in the regular 10 blue links is going to be the mobile non-AMP version of your site. The reason why this is happening. So a lot of things have changed in the last 10 years. It's not that desktop use has decreased, it's that mobile use has increased to a point where basically everybody has a portable access to the internet in their pocket, in their hand at all times. So Google has to respond to that. So here's what you need to do. If your site is not mobile friendly at this point, you need to make that a priority very quickly. And here's why. At this point, the world is basically driven by smartphones. If you are not investing in having a mobile friendly version of your site, Google is just going to figure that you don't care about your customers as much as all the other businesses on Earth that have mobile-friendly sites. Like I said, they've been giving people heads up on this for at least 3.5 years. That's more than ample time to get a mobile-friendly site up in place. So basically, they figure if you don't care about it, they shouldn't either. The other thing that's of prime importance, since we're talking about mobile first, is you need to prioritize having a site that loads quickly. Google usually does not come out and tell people exactly what goes into their ranking algorithm. It's very rare that they tip their hand and just outright say some of the things that go into the ranking algorithm. But on the page, on the Google site where they're talking about mobile first indexing, they very clearly state that sites that do not load quickly may be downranked. They may be devalued versus similar sites that load quickly. So if you're in a competitive vertical of any kind, if you're competing for a local SEO, if you're on a national scale trying to sell industrial products or services to a bunch of different people, you need to have a fast loading site. That's just bottom line, because they've said it. They don't normally just come out and say stuff like this, but they're basically saying if your site doesn't load fast and every other site in your competitive market loads quicker than yours, then you are probably going to be downranked. There's a lot of ways that you can do this. You can optimize your site for speed in a lot of different ways. One of the biggest ways is to get on good hosting. There's a lot of optimizations that you can do from that point. Get on a good web host that prioritizes speed. Again, if you're on a WordPress site, you can get with a host like a Kinsta, like WP Engine, that prioritizes speed. And the third thing that you should really do is make sure that the information on your mobile site and your desktop site are the same. Google is going to be looking at the mobile version of your web pages. The pages on your site should match the information that's on the desktop version. If you have less information on the mobile versions of those pages, then that's something to look at and reevaluate. Here's another excerpt that I found very interesting from the page on Google's site about mobile-first indexing. So they said it's not automatically a thing where you're going to get downranked, depending on these things. If your site has the most relevant content for that search query, meaning the things that people type in, if your page answers it the best out of everybody else, then they might still choose to show that at the top of search rankings, even if it's slow loading, even if it's not mobile friendly. But I would not put too much faith in that, because in any competitive category, there's going to be a lot of content. The chances are very high in any competitive industry or market that somebody else is going to have a page that answers those questions as good as your page or better. If anybody wants to rank their site, these are the things that I would prioritize in this order. Number one, making sure that you have the most relevant content for the search query that you're trying to rank for. Meaning, if somebody types in a search phrase, make sure that your content for that page, your target page, is the best in class of anybody else in your category. And then second priority, make sure that it's mobile friendly. Because again, Google is going to do a mobile first index, meaning they are indexing the mobile version of those pages first, and they are going to give priority to mobile pages over desktop. Third, and equally important, make sure that the site loads quickly. The reason for this is a lot of people are on mobile, they're on their phone, they're not at their desk in their office. So a lot of people are just out in the street, out and about, everybody's got a phone. Not everybody's data speed is the best. So that's why speed is a priority. Make sure that you're on a host that prioritizes speed. Don't get that $5 a month hosting. Spend a little bit more, get on a web host that prioritizes speed and has good time to first byte. And the last thing I would say too, make sure that you have structured data on these pages. This is part of a separate thing where Google is building out the knowledge graph or the entity graph. Make sure that your structured data, your schema or your microformats data matches on mobile and desktop. If you have a mobile friendly site that basically is a responsive design and you use one code base for both the desktop and the mobile version, and it just kind of rearranges the content to be mobile friendly, then you're in good shape because you're going to have the same structured data markup. If you don't know what structured data is, it's hidden markup that basically tells Google a little bit more about your entity. All kinds of things can be entities, whether it's a person, a company, a thing, an idea, a country, and Google is moving toward this. This is a whole nother discussion about the entity graph, but just making sure that all the data from your desktop site and your mobile site match, including the structured data. In most cases, it takes care of itself. The only time that you should be worried is if you have either different web address for your mobile versions of your pages, or if you're using some sort of plugin or app to serve up different versions of those pages. Close it out. If you have a SEO question that you'd like to see us answer, go ahead and put it in the comments below. We will answer it in a video for you. If you're getting value from this channel, don't forget to subscribe. We're getting more subscribers. We're putting out videos at least once a week, giving you SEO tips for industrial and manufacturing companies. That's what we specialize in at Lockedown Design and SEO. So I'll see you in the next video, and peace. Okay. So,